Hi, this is Joy and welcome to my first video tutorial experiment. Since I am not a native English speaker, I am making use of Poly service. It is a text-to-speech service provided by Amazon AWS Cloud Platform.
This tutorial is about setting up PlantUML for coding C4 architecture diagrams. Why C4 architecture model and what it solves in software architecture is already available in the blog post. The URL is present in the description section for easy access. Here we will be seeing how to set up the environment as described in the post. Let's start. First, install Java. That will make sure the path variable is set properly. Then install Graphviz. There is no issue installing in different order as those are not dependent. Now let's install Graphviz. It is easy as double-clicking the installer and pressing some next buttons in the wizard. During the installation, let's see where to download the Graphviz software. It is free to use. Thanks to the developers of Graphviz. Finding Graphviz in internet is easy. Just fire up an existing or new browser session. Google the term download Graphviz Windows. Mostly the first link would be the place to go. In case we are not seeing it, the specific URL is https://graphviz.gitlab.io/download. It is mentioned in description as well. We can get the source code, if needed. The installer used in this video is Windows Install Package. Let's go back to installation and check how far it completed the installation process. Yes, it is completed. We can see the Graphviz software installed in the Programs and Features view of Control Panel. We now have Java runtime and Graphviz installed in our system. We will be using Microsoft Visual Studio Code for coding the architecture diagrams. It doesn't have out-of-box support for PlantUML diagrams, but we can get it by using extensions. Let's see what is next step. The next step is to download and install Visual Studio Code. This machine already has Visual Studio Code installed. If it is not, it can be easily located by Google search. Let's fire up VSCode and see the PlantUML extension. Visual Studio Code takes time based on the machine config and resource availability. Usually it's really fast to load up. Once we get the VSCode is ready to use, we need to add the PlantUML extension. To do so, let's go to Extensions view. Simply search for PlantUML. Mostly the first one is what we need. In case there are more in future, please note the extension author name Jebs, which is used in this tutorial. Big thanks to Jebs for making a good extension for the community. There is one more step left. PlantUML doesn't support C4 architecture diagrams out of the box. In order to get the support, we need C4 architecture library. Libraries are similar to CSS style sheets, if we consider PlantUML as HTML. Let's open C4 architecture library in GitHub. It has all different types of diagrams such as context, container and component as separate libraries. But if we get container library, it would be having the shapes for context as well. Let's download the container library from GitHub. To download, click on the raw button. This opens the raw file. Press Ctrl plus S button. This opens the file save dialog box. Give a location where to download as we do for any download operation in browser. Here the path used is little long and typing takes time. Once the location is set, hit the save button to complete the download process. Let's see how all this works together next. The C4 Architecture Library GitHub site has good documentation on how to use the library. First is about how to include the library into our code. We can download and include from our local folder. Another way is to refer to the original file in this repository. The next interesting thing here in this repository is the sample PlantUML code for C4 architecture diagram. Let's see how this sample can be used in our machine. In order to see the sample code in action, we need the editor and its Visual Studio Code. We are back in Visual Studio Code. First, we need a file to copy-paste the code from the C4 library's GitHub repository. Let's create a file named container. The extension used here is .puml. Once the file editing window is available, paste the sample code. Next, we need to see the diagram. The magic shortcut is Alt plus D. Press Alt plus D. It will open the preview pane at the right side. It shows processing. Till the processing is completed in the background. Remember, we installed couple of software. All has to work to get this preview working. Let's talk some internal how all these are working. PlantUML extension running inside Visual Studio Code triggers Java with corresponding PlantUML.jar file included within the plugin. Also passes the text we just copy-pasted into the editor. It understands the diagram text and uses Graphviz software to find the right graphical points for the shapes. Finally, diagram rendered. Let's do some changes to diagram text. First, we are changing the system in this example to represent www.joymanonline.in website. It is just a personal profile site. All static contents, nothing fancy. It normally updates automatically the diagram shown in right side of the screen. If not, we can press the shortcut key Alt plus D. The system has two properties to change. The name and the description. Though this diagram contains container and relation objects, let's take person to modify. We are now changing the person's label to internet user. By this time the system details change to joymanonline.in. As we are seeing, the person details are not yet reflected in the diagram. Without waiting for the automatic refresh of diagram, let's try the Alt plus D shortcut. This triggers command to refresh the right side diagram from the textual contents in the left side. It's taking some time. This time, as it is a demo, a bit more than the usual time. But at last the right side will be changed and show the latest diagram text. Yes, we got it changed.